This is the ProcessBook button icon. I can use this to draw a button that will make a link to an existing ProcessBook display in the same ProcessBook or a separate ProcessBook. Or I can launch an operating system command with it, like a word processor and Excel spreadsheet. I can make links to specific Excel spreadsheets. And it's just a very, in general, a good navigation tool, a nice option that's available to you for navigating in a way that's other than just on the main menu. So if I choose draw button, or if I click on the button icon, I can go ahead and draw a button shape. On that button shape, I can then make reference, or with that button shape, I'll make reference to an existing display. In this case, I'm going to call this, let's call this a main column bottom. If you recall, that was the display that we used in our demos earlier. We'll say this is two main column bottom. And I'm going to go ahead and browse. We're going to browse for all of our different displays. So this is going to look in all the current open ProcessBook files. It's going to look for any display name. And if I simply search for everything, it'll find every display in my currently open ProcessBook. So here's the one called main column bottom. I could have also just typed in main search and would find that. Whoops, this is a substring search. Look for the word main, there we go, without the asterisk. And that's now making a reference to this main column bottom. Now, we have the choice to either open this in a new window or have this open in the existing window, replacing the existing window. I'm going to open this in a new window, mostly because I haven't saved this display yet, and if I simply open it in the existing window, it's going to prompt me to save. This isn't a problem, I just don't want to see that right now. Also, you have the choice to use either relative path or absolute path. There are benefits to both. Sometimes if you're going to move an entire process book and all the related process books, the relative path can of course save the day when you're doing that. So let me go ahead and say OK. Here's my icon. Needs to be a little bit bigger. There we go. And the point of all this is now when I click on this, this is going to go out and run that display. As you can see, it opened it into a new window. There we go. So this is searching for existing displays wherever they might be using this directory structure. And there's other things that you can search for in addition to just browsing for them outright. Now, in this case, what I'd like to do is actually find not the display, but I'm going to be making a reference to an actual ProcessBook workbook. So I just wanted to show you that to show you that you can search for displays elsewhere. Now the ProcessBook file is simply going to be a PIW file that contains the other ProcessBook displays. And as you can see, this is going out and finding this within my documents. It's called myprocessbook.piw. This is just a test program that I put there. Or a test PIW. I'll just call this my process book. And we'll also use that in a new window. So the result of this is when I click on this, it's going to go out and launch this process book file. It's a process book display that's got two pages, and a process book workbook here that's got two pages, and one of them has a display on it. That's the display. So every time I click on this, this is going to go out and launch that PIW file. Now finally, we can make reference to existing applications or workbooks or documents associated with applications like Excel workbooks or Microsoft Word documents for documentation. So let me give you an example of that. I'll go ahead and create another button. And for this button, instead of using browsing for files, we're going to browse for applications. And this will go out and allow us to find any application we need to make access to. So for example, I can go into here, look in the Windows directory, and look for Notepad, for example. And now this is going to go ahead and launch that. There we go. Now I can make reference to other applications as well. For example, I can just do a reference to calc.exe. It's the Windows calculator. And that's going to go out and find that calculator and run it for me. Now let me do one last button. I'll just create this by dragging this with the control key pressed, and that's going to make a duplicate. So now what I'd like to do is browse out for a spreadsheet. So we're going to look for all files. I'm going to go into where we have the solutions stored for these labs. And we'll go into SR Client Tools. I'll just open up this workbook. This is a workbook from some of our learning labs. Let's go ahead and launch this. This is going to go out and launch a copy of the associated application, Excel in this case, and then launch that shift report. And we've seen people make good use of this for things like Word documents to go to operating instructions or shift reports or analysis of one type or another.